CCTV Camera World is proud to provide support for products purchased from our website. If you purchased your product from another vendor, please contact the vendor you purchased from for further assistance. In this video, I'm going to show you a quick overview of the Super Live Plus app for the QT Series products. First, I'm going to tap to open the app. There's a little splash screen here. You can see I have the Office DVR added here. If I wanted to check for other devices that I've added to the app, I would tap the down pointing caret or down pointing arrow next to Office DVR. And this is a list of my devices. So if I were to tap the play button on the Office DVR, I would get the cameras from my Office DVR. Since it is an 8-channel recorder, it brought up a 9-camera grid view and then populated the 8 cameras that are connected to the DVR. Really, I only have 4 cameras connected, and in reality, it's only 1 camera with a 4 splitter, so the image looks the same. However, here I have the live view of my DVR's channels. If I wanted to bring one of these channels into full screen, I would double tap that channel. If I wanted to take it back out of full screen, I would double tap it again. You can even rotate your screen to bring the live view into kind of a full screen view. And then rotate your phone back into portrait mode to bring back all of the menu options. If I made my grid screen smaller by tapping the grid icon in the center and then choosing the 4-camera grid view, I can cycle through each 4-camera grid view by clicking the next arrow. So as you saw, I was on channel 01 through 04. By tapping the right arrow, I'm now on 05 through 08. If I wanted to get back to 01 to 04, I would tap the left arrow. If I wanted to close all the channels, I would hit the icons to the right of the arrows. That's to close all the channels. And then if I wanted to choose which cameras to view individually, I would choose that channel selection button to the left of the left and right arrows. So by tapping on that, I can see the cameras listed here with camera names, or I can see the cameras listed here as these neat little circles with the channel numbers. So that's the two ways that you can see the live views for those cameras. Now, if my cameras had two-way talk, I could tap the microphone icon. It's going to ask me to interact with my microphone on the iPhone. I'm going to click OK to allow that. However, I know that these cameras do not have two-way audio, so I'm going to exit out of the two-way audio interface. On the second option there, there is audio. If you wanted to listen to audio from your camera, if it supports audio, you can do that, and then you can tap to mute that particular channel. I've already showed you the grid screen options here. There's a 1 grid screen option, a 4, 9, 16, and some other neat options at the bottom. I'm going to tap back out of this menu. Now, if you actually wanted to play back recorded footage from your DVR, you would need to tap the little camera reel icon on the bottom. And that's going to take you to the remote playback screen. Here you can see at around noon, we can see that we pulled up the footage here, and we can choose the playback speed here. We can speed it up by tapping it again. It'll go back to 1x speed. I can do reverse playback by tapping the left arrows. It went back to the beginning of my channel. If I click the arrow buttons, again, it's gonna go between cameras, channels on my recorder as I'm playing back the footage. And then last but not least, there is the close channel button. Down here, you can see where you can choose the date that you want to see footage from. And then the red numbers indicate that there is recorded footage there. For example, in May, I had some footage on the 27th, I had some footage on the 31st, and then of course I have footage that I'm playing now from June 9th. Last but not least, you can also subscribe to push notifications by going back to the live screen view, tapping the 3 lines at the top left-hand side of the app, and then clicking on either the push setting and then tapping the enable push message. And then of course you can subscribe to whichever channels you would like those from. Of course, those features also need to be enabled on the DVR for you to receive the push notification from the system. And then you would tap the floppy disk icon to save those settings. There's the other notification settings can be found under notifications here. This is actually a list of notifications. If you've received a push notification, you can choose to delete it or check it that you've actually addressed what that push notification was sent for. So this is just a list of push notifications. So push setting is where you enable it,
And then notifications is where you see which push notifications you've received from your system. Hopefully this video helps give you a good overview of the app for the Qt.
If you're watching on YouTube, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe.